Obviously stronger than expected numbers. And I think that comes as a big surprise, particularly when people start thinking about your industry and the challenges that it's facing. First of all, hiring, not very easy to get people in. And I'm guessing you're paying more for every worker that you have to bring in. And second of all, food inflation, other inflation that might creep in. So tell me a little bit about what happened and what you saw during the quarter.
Sure. It has been a very challenging few weeks. You're absolutely right. And as we become more and more focused on the Delta variant and learning about it and its implications, it really has been a unique moment in time, right? Because at a time when we're focusing again on COVID in a way perhaps we didn't expect, we also posted a really strong quarter in that, you know, Americans came back to restaurants the last quarter, and both Applebee's and IHOP gained share versus their competitors. Applebee's is now at 110% of its pre-COVID volume in 2019. And Applebee's and IHOP, excuse me, is at 98.5%. So at a time when there's this new uncertainty in the marketplace, both brands perform really well because Americans have returned to restaurants in Q1 and in Q2.
Has that changed in the last few weeks as Delta becomes a bigger concern?
As you can imagine, we're looking at it very closely. And as we look at the period before Delta became a concern about the end of June, early July, up until now, we have not seen a change in patterns nationally, nor have we seen a significant change in patterns in the hotspot locations across the U.S.
So how do you deal with things like staffing? Is it difficult to get people in? Are you having to pay them more money?
It is difficult. Staffing is a challenge for us and for the entire industry. What I can tell you is that nationwide, again, for both brands, Applebee's and IHOP's, we're at about 85% of where we should be when it comes to fully staffed restaurants. Some restaurants are a little bit better, some restaurants are a little bit worse. And so our franchisees, who do most of the hiring, because 98% of our restaurants are owned and operated by others, are doing things like hiring incentives. They've put in place bonuses. So if a current team member refers a family or a friend member, and wages, both back of house and front of house, are up $1, $2, or $3. But what I think is very interesting right now is that despite the short staffing in many of our restaurants, our guest satisfaction scores, Becky, are as high as they've ever been, and they've reached pre-pandemic levels. And what that tells me is that the team members we have across the country are so proud and enthusiastic to be back at work and welcoming Americans back into their restaurants that they're delivering great service. And the other thing that we're seeing is that Americans right now are very understanding of the stress of restaurant workers and other frontline workers. And what's really interesting is that tips are up this year versus 2019. So Americans have come back, and I think they're generous, and they're happy to be in restaurants.
Good. They should recognize what those people who are working are doing for them. That's good to hear. So your customer satisfaction levels are up. What about your staffing satisfaction levels? Do you do surveys to ask the people who are actually working on the line what they think?
Yes, and to be clear, you know, at Dine Brands, we do employee satisfaction surveys for the 69 restaurants that we own. And then our franchisees do it for the 3,500 restaurants that they own. But in the 69 restaurants that we own, which happen to be in North and South Carolina, we've had the best engagement scores that we've had in years. And we interpret that the same way that we interpret Americans tipping well, which is that people are happy to be back at what they love doing after a year of being locked up in their homes, you know, despite the uncertainty we've seen in the last couple of weeks.